If you live each day as if it was your last, someday you'll most certainly be right.
During your life, you need to make sure that you take advantage of each and every opportunity that has been presented to you each and every day. For the sole reason being, you never know when today is going to be your last day. You don't know what tomorrow holds, and you never will. There's no way to predict the future. So you need to live every single day as if it was your last day here on Earth. You need to go out there and do some crazy stuff that you've always dreamt of imagining doing.
Probably I would just turn up the volume on it because the last few years have reminded me that life is fragile.
If you've always wanted to go skydiving, try to figure out a way to go skydiving at least once in your life as soon as you possibly can. Even if that's terrifying to you, it's been said that on the other side of fear is complete bliss. A lot of times people are terrified of things that they don't even know because they don't know how to handle that emotion or that experience. So then when they're presented with that time or that experience, they don't know how to react, and so they act terrified. Yet after they realize it's not a scary thing, they truly love it, and they get to see the fullest effect of how much fun life can truly be. Too many people in today's world are scared of the simplest things, such as talking to strangers or anything like that, meeting new people. So many people are terrified of that, and that can totally change your world for the better by introducing to yourselves the people you could have never thought possible. You want to really get out of your comfort zone as much as you can in your life, so that way you can truly grow.
You have to be run by ideas, not hierarchy. The best ideas have to win.
I never graduated from college, and this is the closest I've ever gotten to a college graduation. I naively chose a college that was almost as expensive as Stanford, and all of my working class parents' savings were being spent on my college tuition. So I decided to drop out and trust that it would all work out okay. When I was 17, I read a quote that went something like, "If you live each day as if it was your last, someday you'll most certainly be right." I've looked in the mirror every morning and asked myself, if today were the last day of my life, would I want to do what I am about to do today? And whenever the answer has been no for too many days in a row, I know I need to change something. Remembering that you are going to die is the best way I know to avoid the trap of thinking you have something to lose. You are already naked. There is no reason not to follow your heart.
Probably I would just turn up the volume on it because the last few years have reminded me that life is fragile.
As some of you may know, about 5 months ago, I had a liver transplant. So I now have the liver of a mid-20s person who died in a car crash and was generous enough to donate their organs. And I wouldn't be here without such generosity. So I hope all of us can be as generous and elect to become organ donors. I'd like to take a moment and thank everybody in the Apple community for the heartfelt support I got too. It really meant a lot. And I'd also like to especially thank Tim Cook and the entire executive team of Apple. They really rose to the occasion and ran the company very ably in that difficult period. So thank you guys.
Tell you what our goal is. Our goal is to make the best personal computers in the world and to make products we are proud to sell and would recommend to our family and friends. And we want to do that at the lowest prices we can. But I have to tell you, there's some stuff in our industry that we wouldn't be proud to ship, that we wouldn't be proud to recommend to our family and friends. And we can't do it. We just can't ship junk. So there are thresholds that we can't cross because of who we are. But we want to make the best personal computers in the industry. And what you'll find is our products are usually not premium priced. You go and price out our competitors' products, and you add the features that you have to add to make them useful, and you'll find in some cases they are more expensive than our products. The difference is we don't offer stripped down, lousy products. We just don't offer categories of products like that. But if you move those aside and compare us with our competitors, I think we compare pretty favorably. And a lot of people have been doing that and saying that now for the last 18 months.
One of the keys to Apple is Apple's an incredibly collaborative company. And you know how many committees we have at Apple? Zero. We have no committees. We are organized like a startup. One person's in charge of iPhone OS software. One person's in charge of Mac hardware. One person's in charge of iPhone hardware engineering. Another person's in charge of worldwide marketing. Another person's in charge of operations. We're organized like a startup. We're the biggest startup on the planet. And we all meet for 3 hours once a week, and we talk about everything we're doing, the whole business. And there's tremendous teamwork at the top of the company, which filters down to tremendous teamwork throughout the company. And teamwork is dependent on trusting the other folks to come through with their part without watching them all the time, but trusting that they're gonna come through with their parts. And that's what we do really well. And we're great at figuring out how to divide things up into these great teams that we have and all work on the same thing, touch bases frequently, and bring it all together into a product. We do that really well.
Thank you all so much for watching the video. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel if you're new, and let us know what you thought in the comment section down below.